Good evening and welcome to our service of choral evensong for the day of Pentecost. This is the day when we remember that the Holy Spirit was poured out upon the apostles and they went out and preached Jesus as Christ. And so we also pray that the Holy Spirit may be poured out upon us, that we too may give witness to our Lord and praise his name. We sit for the psalm and we stand to sing, stand as the choir sings the Gloria at the end of the psalm.
For the sacred my holy name, which you have profaned among the nations to which you came. I will sanctify my great name, which has been profaned among the nations, and which you have profaned among them. And the nations shall know that I am the Lord, says the Lord God, when through you I display my holiness before their eyes. I will take you from the nations, and gather you from all the countries, and bring you into your own land. I will sprinkle clean water upon you, and you shall be clean from all your uncleannesses. And from all your idols I will cleanse you. A new heart I will give you, and a new spirit I will put within you. And I will remove from your body the heart of stone, and give you a heart of flesh. I will put my spirit within you, and make you follow my statutes, and be careful to observe my ordinances. Then you shall live in the land that I gave to your ancestors, and you shall be my people, and I will be your God. Here ends the first reading.
Thank you. taken from Acts, chapter 2, starting at verse 22. You that are Israelites, listen to what I have to say. Jesus of Nazareth, a man attested to you by God with deeds of power, wonders, and signs that God did through him among you, as you yourself know. This man handed over to you according to the definite plan and foreknowledge of God. You crucified and killed by the hands of those outside the law. But God raised him up, having freed him from death, because it was impossible for him to be held in its power. But David says concerning him, I saw the Lord always before me, for he is at my right hand, so that I will not be shaken. Therefore, my heart was glad, and my tongue rejoiced. Moreover, my flesh will live in hope, for you will not abandon my soul to Hades, or let your Holy One experience corruption. You have made known to me the ways of life. You will make me full of gladness with your presence. Fellow Israelites, I may say to you confidently of our ancestor David, that he both died and was buried, and his tomb is with us to this day. Since he was a prophet, he knew that God had sworn with an oath to him that he would put one of his descendants on the throne. Foreseeing this, David spoke of the resurrection of the Messiah, saying, he was not abandoned to Hades, nor did his flesh experience corruption. This Jesus God raised up, and of that all of us are witnesses. Being therefore exalted at the right hand of God, and having received from the Father the promise of the Holy Spirit, he has poured out this that you both see and hear. For David did not ascend into the heavens, but he himself says, the Lord said to my Lord, sit at my right hand, until I make your enemies your footstool. Therefore, let the entire house of Israel know with certainty that God has made him both Lord and Messiah, this Jesus whom you crucified. Now when they heard this, they were cut to the heart and said to Peter and to the other apostles, brothers, what should we do? Peter said to them, repent and be baptized every one of you in the name of Jesus Christ, so that your sins may be forgiven and you will receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. Here endeth the second lesson.
Thank you. of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, your only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sitteth on the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Give unto thy servants that peace which the world cannot give.
Let us all pray. O God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who after his ascension did send upon the first of the disciples thy promised gift of the Holy Spirit, regard, we pray, the present need of thy church, and grant us by the same Spirit to be endued with power from on high, that we may bear effectual witness to the truth of thy holy gospel, so that those who serve thee may be strengthened and encouraged, and that they who serve thee not may be convicted and converted. Through the same Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Let us pray for ourselves, the gift of the Holy Spirit within our lives. Almighty God, who has fulfilled thy word of promise, and from thy heavenly throne has poured out upon the church the gift of the Holy Spirit, open our hearts, we pray thee, to receive the fullness of his grace and power, that our lives may be strengthened for the service of thy kingdom, and our souls be conformed more and more to the image of thy Son, our Lord and Saviour Jesus Christ. as we look at the world in this week, we give thanks for the peace fire that's been brought about in Israel and Gaza. And we pray for peace between the Jews and the Palestinians. And we pray throughout the world for peace for all mankind. Eternal God, in whose perfect kingdom no sword is drawn, but the sword of righteousness, and no strength known, but the strength of love. So guide and inspire, we pray thee, the labours of those who seek to establish righteousness and peace among the nations, that all peoples may find their security not in force of arms, but in the perfect love that casteth out fear, and in the fellowship revealed to us in thy Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And as our attention has been brought in recent months to the whole business of racism, let us pray that racism may be taken from our hearts. And that we may see and treat all people equal. O God, who has made of one blood all nations to dwell upon the face of the earth, and who by thy Son, Jesus Christ, has broken down the wall of partition between the races of men, break down, we beseech thee, all that divides us from one another. Shame our jealousies, and lay low our pride. Do away all race prejudice, that the bonds of fellowship and mutual service may unite all peoples, and we may live in peace together, to the glory of thy great name. Through the same Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. We say together the grace. Grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all, evermore. Amen. Spirit, be among us and remain with us always.